Hi guys, this is Chaitanya Kulkarni from Attainu Batch Flamingo. This is our shallow dive project called New Scratch. My teammates are Abdullah Sheikh, Khushbu Desai, Mohit Ponna, and Rakesh Sutha. So New Scratch is a news aggregator website which we have developed over News API. News API gathers data from various publishers across the world, especially the big ones such as CNN, BBC, Al Jazeera, Bloomberg, and so on. The technologies we've used are Bootstrap, jQuery, FontAwesome, CSS, 3, News API, which is the main thing, Node.js Express for the backend, Mongoose, Cloudinary, Mongo Atlas, and Heroku for the deployment. So this, as you can see, this is the main page of our app. Every article is on a card, which on click shows a pop-up menu briefing me more about the particular article. I can visit that article website on clicking the link over here, which will open it in the new tab. We've also implemented pagination at the end of the every page. As you can see on the left, we have categories where I can select a particular category, say sports, and I'll get the articles for the same in the middle. On the right, we have the weather widget, which we have implemented with the help of Open Weather API. On the top, we have in the nav bar, we have a search bar where you can search for any query and the app will give you the results for the same. Say, suppose I want to search regarding Italy. So it will give me the results for that country itself or whatever your query is. Moving on to another feature, there are personalized weather, bookmarks, and add interest, which are member exclusive features, meaning the user should be a member and should be logged in. For the default, it gives out the weather for New Delhi, which is the capital of India. So for the member exclusive features, I need to log in first. And for that, I need to be a member, so I need to register. So I'll register over here. The email ID should be unique for every member signing up. Also, we have implemented this country, state, city API to get the location of the member signing up. So I've entered my city. The password should be dynamic, meaning it should have 8 characters. In which there should be upper case characters, lower case characters, digits, and special characters, without which it won't work. So I've registered over here and log in with the same email again. So I have logged in. You can add bookmarks on clicking on the bookmarks button, which is present on every article card. On clicking of the button, the button turns into green, notifying the user that the particular article is bookmarked. The bookmarked articles are stored in my bookmark route, which can be. So these are my bookmarked articles. I can read and visit the articles from over here. And whenever I'm done, I can delete. It gives me confirms whether I should delete the bookmark or not. So the layout remains pretty much the same throughout this application. Apart from the search bar. So as you previously saw, the user can search anything in the search bar and it will give the results for the same. But what if the user searches for that particular term quite often? So previously I searched for Italy. So I'll search it again. And what if I'm so every day coming on the website and so I'm searching it again and again? So for that we have added a feature called add interest. So I'll add it to my interest and it will give me a link over here in the bottom right corner on clicking of which it will give me the results for that particular query itself. And I can add as many of as interests as I want, say Star Wars. It will give me all the results for the same in the middle. Also, as you can see, the weather is showing me for Pune, which was previously showing for the capital, which was Delhi. So the weather is also personalized. The user can visit his profile from over here and can add and update things over here, like phone, age, his country, state, city, but he can't update his email. He can also add up a profile picture. So let's say I'll add a picture over here, change my name, I'll add a phone number. And I'll add the age. If I leave the inputs empty, it won't change that particular thing. And I can also change the password from over here. So as you can see, the profile picture is changed. So yeah, that's about it about NewsCrunch. Hope you guys like it. Thank you.